All right, thank you for coming back. Appreciate you guys being here. If you were here last time, I talked about how these sessions are going to teach you how to do a cash flow statement, which is something very, very good to know how to do. You'll need it for a lot of different classes in business. Cash flow statement is one of those four required financial statements. So let's jump right in. Looking back at the computer and just doing a little bit of review, the cash flow statement, it helps us answer these sort of questions, and that was on your homework as well. And we also talked about what cash equivalents were last time, didn't we? Okay. We talked about how there are three important sections of the cash flow statement. There's the operating activities section, the investing activities section, and the financing activities section. Okay. And then we started talking about being able to properly classify cash flows. Is that correct? And that is a very, very important thing to be able to do. There's your operating cash flows. There's your most common investing cash flows. There's your most common financing cash flows. And we also talked about that category of transactions where there's no cash that actually transacts. There's no cash inflow or outflow. However, they are significant enough that we need to disclose them in a separate note or separate footnote to the cash flow statement. All right? Let's go ahead and take a look at the handout that I wanted you to do. You guys all have that, right? Let's go over the answers to handout number one. Now, the first thing I asked is, what is the purpose of the statement of cash flows? And we talked about this. It's to report all major cash receipts or inflows and cash payments or outflows during a period of time. Helps users answer such questions as, how do we obtain our money? How do we obtain our cash? Money and cash should not be used synonymously like I did there mistakenly. How does a company obtain its cash? Where does a company spend its cash? What explains the change in the cash balance? Okay? Let's say a company purchases a building for $1 million, paying $200,000 in cash and borrowing the remainder with a long-term note payable. How would we report that on the statement of cash flows? Okay, we hadn't really talked about that, but here's how you would do that. The amount of the building purchase that was paid for in cash, the $200,000, it would be reported in the investing activity section of the cash flow statement. However, you would also have a separate footnote or disclosure in your non-cash investing and financing section where you disclose that $800,000 of that building purchase was done in the form of a long-term note payable as opposed to cash. Okay? So that could happen. All right? Any questions on number one and number two? Anybody? Okay, now we're to the meat of potatoes. I want to know if you can classify these cash flows. Okay? So let's go through these, and I want to classify these cash flows as either operating, investing, financing, or if it is instead a non-cash investing financing. Okay? All right, I'll abbreviate here. Purchased a truck with cash. What type of cash flow is that?
Investing.
Okay? Conversion of preferred stock to common stock would be what?
Non-cash.
Purchased inventory.
Operating.
This would be operating. This is something we do in our daily operations. Okay? Collected principal on a long-term note receivable.
Investing.
This would be investing. Okay? Paid employee wages using cash.
Operating.
Purchased common stock in another company as a long-term investment.
Investing.
That would be an investing activity. Paid cash to settle a long-term debt.
Operating.
No, it's not. It's a long-term debt, but when we pay cash to settle a debt, it is a
financing.
Okay? Paying cash to settle a long-term debt is a financing activity. Issuing long-term bonds for cash. What is that?
Financing.
Financing. Okay. Remember the accounting equation? Hope you do. Remember how I said financing activities often have to do with long-term items on that side, and investing activities often have to do with items on that side? This is a long-term bond payable, right? So that would be the right side. That's a financing. Okay? Purchased a piece of land using a long-term note payable.
Non-cash.
That's a non-cash. If you look at that journal entry would look like this. We debit land and we would credit note payable. There's no cash being transacted there, is there? So that's a non-cash. Paid income taxes.
Operating.
That's operating. Paid interest on a note payable.
Operating.
Operating. Payment or receipt of interest is always an operating. Okay? Paid cash for property taxes on a building.
Operating.
That's also operating. Paid withdrawals to owners. What do you think?
Operating.
Financing.
No? That's actually a financing activity. Isn't paying dividends is a financing activity, right?
Right?
Well, withdrawals to owners is like dividends if it's a sole proprietorship or partnership. So withdrawals to owners is financing. Declared and paid a cash dividend, that's there right next, isn't it?
Financing.
That is a financing. Do you see where these are basically the same thing?
Mm-hmm.
It's just depending on the type of company or how they've set it up. Borrowed cash on a long-term note payable. What do you think?
Investment.
On a long-term note payable? Financing. That's how we're financing our company, with a long-term note payable. Okay? We're not investing in any sort of asset. Okay? So that's financing. Purchased a building by issuing common stock.
Non-cash.
That's non-cash. Sold consulting services for cash.
Operating.
Received interest on a bond the company holds as a long-term investment.
Operating.
Receipt or payment of interest is always an operating. Purchased the company's own stock, which is treasury stock, using cash.
Financing.
That's financing. Sold equipment for cash.
Investing.
All right. I know it's not easy to learn these classifications, and that's why I made you these flashcards. Hopefully you cut those out, made your own flashcards, or you just used that information to construct your own. But you have to be able to know how to do classification of cash flows. And you do start to get, you know, you see patterns in it, and you get better at it. Like anything else, if you practice, you'll get better at it. Okay? Any questions on that? Any questions on the classification of cash flows?
Yes. Sir?
Go ahead, Erica, first.
Does every non-cash investing financing activity involve both investing and financing?
That's a great question. And I would say no, because the conversion of, like, preferred stock into common stock, your preferred stock would be decreased, your common stock would be increased. You see what I'm saying? So it's a great question. Nobody's ever asked me that question before. A lot of times it does. Like if you purchase a truck with a long-term note payable, well, the purchasing of the truck is kind of an investing. The issuance of a long-term note payable is kind of a financing. But it doesn't always have to be both of them. Okay? John, did you have a question?
When you do non-cash, do you have to specify either financing or investing?
No, usually we just have a separate schedule. It's either below the cash flow statement or sometimes it's in the notes that just lists out your significant non-cash transactions. And of course, these are significant, okay? If you go buy a computer monitor on credit for $150, that's not significant, okay? Even though there's no, you know, you, so it's gotta be significant. It's gotta be material, all right? Okay. All right. Okay, any other questions? Good questions. Okay, what we are going to do today, let's go back to the computer, all right? We are going to concentrate on determining cash flows from operating activities, okay? Now, the first step in learning how to do a cash flow statement was learning how to classify cash flows. Now we're going to figure out how to calculate cash flows from operating activities, okay? Now, there are two ways that you can do this. There is the direct method and there is the indirect method. Let me show you those. This is the indirect method of calculating cash flows, operating cash flows, I should say. And what is the net cash provided by operating activities? It's 141, right? Now, as a refresher, we have your net cash from operating activities, your net cash from investing activities, and your net cash from financing activities, right? Those are the three sections. So once again, you want to be able to properly classify cash flows so that you can put it in the correct section. Make sense? Well, this is the indirect method of calculating operating cash flows. The next slide is the direct method of calculating operating cash flows. So now I'm going to flip back and forth between these, the indirect method and the direct method. It's $141,000 for operating cash flows if you use the indirect method. What is it if you use the direct method? It's the same number, isn't it? And look at the bottom half of these two statements. Again, let me switch back and forth between these. The bottom half does not change at all, does it? Okay? So the indirect method versus the direct method, that is just different ways of arriving at the same number of $141,000. Okay? The indirect method, the direct method. Now, the direct method has us classify major categories of cash inflows and outflows, such as cash received from customers, cash paid for merchandise, cash paid for income taxes, cash paid for other. And if you add those up, it results in $141,000 net inflow, correct? That's the direct method. The indirect method also arrives at $141,000, but what they do is they start with the net income, in this case $105,000, and they do certain adjustments to it. And then they arrive at that net cash provided by operating activities of $141,000. Are you with me? Okay. So contrast those two cash flow statements on the indirect versus the direct method. Which way do you think, look at those two operating calculations. Whoops. Which do you think is clearer? Which do you think is easier to understand? The direct, I think, is easier to understand. Which do you think is the most commonly in place?
The indirect.
Almost everybody uses the indirect method. Okay? It is the format used most often in practice. So in this class, we're going to first learn the indirect method. The direct method is used very, very, very rarely. Okay? We're going to concentrate today on calculating operating cash flows using the indirect method. Let me say that again. Today's task before us is to calculate cash flows from operating activities using the indirect method. We're not going to worry about the investing section. We're not going to worry about the financing section. We're going to worry about doing this right here. That's what we're going to learn how to do today. Cash flows from operating activities using the indirect method. You with me?